Let's clean and cook a gar.
Take a look at this. It's such a cool fish.
My friend Cha got this fish and gave it to me. So I'm going to try to see if I can actually like clean this and cook and eat it. I'm gonna get a close up on like the body and the scales and everything, cause like the scales is just like armor. It's crazy. So I'm not gonna be able to scale this with my fingernails like I do carp. Take a look at a close up on its teeth. Look at that. And here's its body. Let's see if you can hear it. This is my fingernail up against it. It feels like plastic almost. It's like bone or something. It's crazy. Like, look at this. Such an amazing fish. All right, I'm gonna be honest, I really do not know where to start, but I think I'm just gonna clip off all the fins first, like I usually do on fish. I have a fillet knife, and hopefully this works well, but I might have to switch off to like a more robust knife, but we'll see. But I have these Fiskars shears, and these will definitely work. I am going to just gut it, I guess. The vent is right down here. I'm just gonna cut like this. Wow, that's crazy. Goes all the way through the body like this. It's almost like a snake. I'm gonna grab a spoon and I'm gonna use it to scrape the inside here. All right, I got the spoon here. Open this up and just scrape. All right, what I find really fascinating so far is it feels like a snake or something. And like everything feels very firm, which is crazy. It's so crazy cool. This is amazing. So I'm gonna use the fillet knife. I really don't even know where to start. But let's just go like this or something. Let's see if I can like dig my fillet knife in underneath this. So here's the scale. There you go. I'm underneath. Holy crap. I'm afraid of like breaking the knife. I'm gonna see if I can cut it. I should have watched some videos before I did this, but I'm kind of winging it. So, seems like I'm just gonna be cutting down its spine like this, I guess, with my scissors. And I'm gonna just cut the head off. Okay, so now I'm just gonna cut into it, I guess. My fillet knife is not cutting through the bony, like, scales. Oh, wow. Look at that. It feels very fatty. Like, it has tons of fat on it. Almost like eel or something, which is crazy. Okay. So, let's break this like that. And now I think I can do maybe a proper fillet. Okay, that's not gonna work. Okay, there you go, finally. I think the hard part was getting it filleted around where the fin was, because there's an attachment right here and it just won't come off. It won't come off easily. There you go. Ah, there you go, finally. Nice whole piece of gar. And I can feel the rib bones right here. I'm just gonna keep it. And then all the bones all the way down. I'm gonna keep the bones in because this is where all the fat is. Like all that, that's just pure fat. This reminds me of unagi, actually. Freshwater eel. So yeah, I am going to marinate this in like a Japanese teriyaki or like just unagi sauce or something. And then I'm just gonna grill it. This will be really, really good. This is gonna be cool. So like this, I'm gonna save and I'm gonna fillet it and do whatever with it later. But yeah, let's get this cooking. I want to mention that this right here, the scales that I have left and the skin and all that, this can still actually be used. This, in a survival situation, you can probably just take this, toss it into like a pot or something and cook it down. And you'll get a lot of fat and collagen out of this. So yeah, this is still actually usable, the skin. I am actually just gonna hang it out here. I'm gonna throw some salt on it so that it dehydrates. And so that way bugs aren't like trying to like eat it and stuff like that too. But yeah, I'm just gonna let this sit out and let it dry up and see what ends up happening. If this can become like armor or something, cause like this stuff is really tough. And I'm just salting the skins. But yeah, I'm just gonna leave it like this to see what ends up happening. I ended up filleting both of them and I just have it in some water here. I'm just gonna salt it like this, mix it around. And the salt is kind of just for seasoning for the most part, but this is also to draw out any blood if there is any. And then I'm just mixing it all up like this. So I'm gonna let this sit for about 10 minutes and then I'm gonna dump everything out and wash it. And then I'm gonna let it marinate in some Japanese sauce or something like that. So I figured I should have done some research and I'm gonna change the way I'm gonna cook it. And so what I'm gonna be doing is I have the fillets. There you go. I'm gonna slice them into about 3 pieces. There you go. And another piece here. So instead of marinating it first, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna grill it first and cook it first. And then I'm just going to put the sauce over it and then eat it like that. So I've got some skewers. There you go. So I'm not entirely sure what would be the best way to do this, but I'm just gonna run with it and kind of just wing it. So there you go. This piece, just like that. I don't have a whole lot of skewers, to be honest. There you go. Let's work with just these two for now. And then I'm just gonna place this over it. Yeah, and we're just gonna grill. I'll lower the heat a little bit. I might have to do it one at a time. And it's burning my skewers too. Dang. Yep, this is not gonna work. All right, I ran inside and grabbed some tongs. There you go. Let's try this again. Now this is actually working a lot better than I would expect. This is not sticking to the grill or anything. And it's actually cooking the meat. I feel like this would not work with many other types of fish. I feel like because this is so fatty that this is working. The meat seems very firm, very, very reminiscent of unagi, a freshwater eel. It's not getting scorched completely either. It's not like burning like a ton. This is just perfect. This is really nice. I'm pleasantly surprised. My only problem with this is once I'm done cooking and put my sauce over it and then eat it, it's gonna be full of bones because that's just how it is. So like this piece here looks like it's done. I'm gonna put it off to the side. This piece looks done also. This one is done. So I'll place those on the side and cook the rest. These are the tail sections. And look at that. It's just cooking right on top. Not even getting stuck or anything. I feel like if I were to cook like crappie or something like that on here, it's just gonna stick and then it's gonna flake off and it's just gonna be a mess. This is so cool. All right, while that's cooking, let me talk to you about the sauce that I got. So I got this sauce here. It's called This Little Goat Went to Tokyo. It's sweet and salty. It's an everything sauce. And it's really good. It's similar to like an unagi sauce. And yeah, this is going to be perfect for this. So what I plan to do is I'm going to lower the heat, pull these over. It doesn't need to really continue to cook. So I'm going to just take the sauce, put it over like this. And I'm going to use a small brush like this and just kind of brush it also to get it all over the meat. Ooh, it's charring a little bit here, which is fine. So a little bit more sauce. This is gonna make my stove completely messy, but I mean, I feel like this is worth it. So I'm gonna turn up the heat completely max for a few seconds. Look at that. Now I'm gonna flip it. This is just to caramelize the sauce. Ah, yeah. Perfect. Now off. This looks good. All right, let's plate it. Now, I'm going to add a little bit more sauce. There you go. It's perfect. It's like unagi. Just like unagi. Like, look at that. Perfect. So let's give it a try. I'm gonna try the belly section here. The meatiest part. See, look at that. All right. Okay, got some bone. This section right up here doesn't have any bones. Holy crap. It's very firm in texture and very meaty. It's not fishy at all. This is very good meat. Holy crap. Wow. I am getting some bones here in this section, and eating around it isn't a problem. But yeah, this is very, very different from your usual fish. This is very good. Wow. Mmm. Oh man. This has a bunch of bones. And it's easy to kind of like eat still, even though there's a bunch of bones like this. Let's see if I can just remove the bones like this here. Let's see. Oh, they just come all in a row like this, all attached. There you go. Off. And I hope that this is a boneless piece. Mmm. Oh my god. Really? All boneless right there. This is the bone. And yeah, the meat is very good. The meat is, yeah, like I said, it's very meaty. It's not flaky like how fish usually is. And there's some spring to it. And it's almost like a very light rubberiness to it too. Similar to like a very, very tender piece of like octopus or squid or something. Like it has that firmness. And I'm not running into like a whole lot of problems with the bones. It's very easy to avoid the bones and eat around it and still have like a satisfying bite. Because of the Y bones and stuff in carp, sometimes it is like annoying to eat it, because if you're not filleting it right, or if you don't know how to process it right, you're gonna be getting like a mouthful of bones every single bite. And then it kind of detracts from the experience of eating fish, because you have to like pick up bones all the time. But I'm not like, I don't hate it, and it's not too much of a problem, but it just makes me appreciate like boneless pieces more, like this. See? Not a problem. But here's another tail section. Mmm. Yeah, the tail section is boneless. And then you get to the body cavity. It has ribs all the way down. If you remember me opening it up and it's body cavity, all the way down is body cavity, has bones. Sort of like through the two ribs. But aside from that, yeah. I mean, this piece right here, right now, I've just removed all of the bones. Mmm. Yeah. Gar is an incredible fish. I have to say that this does beat walleye. I like this more than walleye now. Yeah, definitely. The only problem with this is it's just so hard to clean. I want to go and catch my own gar now. I have not successfully been able to catch my own gar, and I really want to. And yeah, this makes me want to catch one all the more. Absolutely amazing. And cooking it like this too is perfect. It seems pretty like easy, you know, you just grill it, cook it, and then you just put this sauce over it, and it's like this nice sweet and salty sauce, and it's perfect. And then it caramelizes and kind of burns on the outside and chars like this, and it's just so good. And yeah, the bones are not a problem, easily avoidable. Yeah. Mmm. And that char gives it like another layer of flavor as well. Well, that's it for today's video. This is my clean and cook gar. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time. All right. Peace out.